before the descent of Isa, the Muslim shall be the rulers of the earth. Shall have the greatest authority, أكبر سلطة, upon this earth. فيخرج الدجال ليقضي على هذه القوة. The Dajjal shall descend and shall come. The Dajjal shall come in order to take this power away from the Muslims once again. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الذي رواه الإمام ابن خزيمة وابن ماجة والحاكم وصححه الألباني, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: يا أيها الناس, إنها لم تكن فتنة على وجه الأرض منذ ذرع الله آدم إلى قيام الساعة أكبر أو أعظم من الدجال. Mankind, know that there is no greater test or calamity or trial for you from the time Adam was created till the day of judgment, greater test than the Masih al-Dajjal. سمي مسيح كما يقول ابن الأثير في جامع الأصول لأن عينه اليمنى ممسوحة. He is called Masih or wiped because his right eye is wiped away. He cannot see with it. وسمي دجالا كما يقول ابن حجر في فتح الباري لأنه يغطي الحق بالباطل. He is named a deceiver and a dajjal because he tries to cover up and extinguish truth with falsehood. This Masih al-Dajjal, the greatest test upon the face of the earth for mankind from the time of Adam, shall come. This is why the Rasul described in sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fully for us. How he looks, what is written upon him, what he will wear, everything. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الذي رواه الإمام البخاري إنه رجل. First, he is a man, meaning he is a human being who is male. He is not something exotic or an alien or an internet. He is a human being. إنه رجل أحمر, who is of red complexion. جثيم, overweight and heavy. جعد الرأس, extremely curly hair. أعور عينيه اليمنى, his right eye is extinguished, cannot see with it. كأن عينه عنبة طافية, as if his right eye bulges out like a grape. This is how it looks. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الذي رواه الإمام أحمد وأبو نعيم في الحلية وصححه الألباني: والدجال عينه خضراء. The eye that he can see with is green. He has a green eye. His eye is green colored. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم, describing to us the Dajjal fully, لم يبعث نبي إلا وقد أنظر قومه الأعور الكذاب. There is no prophet that was sent by Allah except that he warned his people of the one-eyed liar. إنه ألا إنه أعور. You must know that he is one-eyed. وإن ربكم ليس بأعور. And know that your Lord is not one-eyed. Meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no blemish, has no mistake in him. While the Dajjal, who shall come and say that he is Allah, and shall come and lie and say that he is God, he has a mistake in the way he looks. Bulging out eyes, cannot cure himself. How can he be a God? أعور العينين وإن ربكم ليس بأعور. وإن بين عينيه مكتوب كافر. And written upon his forehead is the word disbeliever. And this is something that is truly stamped on him, written on him. It is not something that is going to be imagined. Why? Because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in another hadith, which is not in Bukhari, which is authentic also, he said, يَقْرَأُهَا, it will be read. يَقْرَأُهَا كُلُّ مُؤْمِنْ كَاتِبْ وَغَيْرِ كَاتِبْ. Every believer who truly believes in Allah shall be able to read it whether he can read or write or not. Whether he knows how to read or write or not, because he believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Dajjal shall come with great magic and great power. From them, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في الصحيحين as is متفق عليه agreed upon, ليس من بلد إلا سيطأها الدجال إلا مكة والمدينة. No country or city except that the Dajjal shall enter it. except two, Mecca and Medina. Meaning he has the ability to move around quickly, entering every city upon the face of the earth. وَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ To give us hope, as is narrated in Sahih Muslim, لَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ بِمَا مَعَ الدَّجَّالِ مِنَ الدَّجَّالِ Verily I, صلى الله عليه وسلم, says, have more knowledge of what the Dajjal possesses in power than he knows about himself. معه نهران يجريان. He shall have two rivers flowing. نهر رقي العين ماء أبيض. One river, when you look at it, it is clear, crystal clear, flowing cold water. والآخر رقي العين نار تتأجج. And the other river, when you look at it, it is as if it is fire boiling, meaning like molten lava. So the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives this advice. فَإِنْ أَدْرَكَلْنَا أَحَدَكُمْ If any of you is to meet this situation, فَلْيَأْتِ الَّذِي يَرَاهُ نَارِ Let him come to the river that he sees is fire. وَلْيُغْمِضْ عَيْنَهُ Let him close his eyes. وَلْيُطَأْطِئْ رَأْسَهُ And let him lower his head. وَلْيَشْرَبْ And let him drink from this water that he thinks is fire. فَإِنَّهُ مَاءٌ بَارِدٌ For it is truly cold and refreshing water. رواه الإمام مسلم صحيح. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم So that we know that the shayateen shall be given help in the Dajjal and he shall control them. The devil shall be controlled by this one-eyed deceiver. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم وَإِنَّ مِنْ فِتْنَتِهِ And from this test that he will give to mankind, أَنْ يَقُولَ لِلْأَعْرَابِي That he will tell a man or a Bedouin, أَرَأَيْتَ إِنْ بَعَثْتُ لَكَ أَبَاكَ وَأُمِّكَ أَتُؤْمِنُ بِي If I was to raise your dead father and your dead mother back to life, would you believe in me? And the man will say, نعم. فَيَتَمَثَّلُ الشَّيْطَانُ بِصُورَةِ أَبِيهِ فِي صُورَةِ أَبِيهِ وَصُورَةِ أُمِّهِ فَيَقُولَنَّ أي الشيطان يقول يا بني اتبعه فإنه ربك The shaytan shall stand in front of the man and come in the form of his father and mother and they shall tell him my son and they are liars devil shaytan my son follow him for he is your God for he is your God this is the power that the Dajjal possesses and it is only given to him by Allah in order to test the resolve and the ability of mankind's belief in Allah the most powerful and most high. And the Rasul has told us where the Dajjal shall enter the earth from. As is narrated, قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمِ in the hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad وَالْتِرْمِذِي وَابْنِ خُزَيْمَةَ وَالْحَاكِمُ وَصَحَحَهُ الْأَلْبَانِيِّ الدَّجَّالُ يَخْرُجُ مِنْ بَلَدٍ مِنْ أَرْضٍ بِالْمَشْرِقِ يُقَالُ لَهَا قَرَتَانَ The Dajjal shall enter upon the earth from the east, from a city named Khorasan, which is a city that is known to most of us in Persia, in the Persian region. وَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ When the Sahaba asked him, this great power that the Dajjal is coming with, how long will he be upon the earth? فَقَالْ أَرْبَعُونَ يَوْمًا 40 days. So the Sahaba asked 40 days. فَقَالَ يَوْمٌ كَسَلًا The first day he is on the earth, it will be the time of 1 year. Not it will seem like 1 year, it will be the time of 1 year. وَيَوْمٌ كَسَلًا And the second day shall be the night, the actual night of a month. وَيَوْمٌ كَجُمْعًا And a day that is as long as a full week. وَسَائِرُ أَيَّامِهِ كَأَيَّامِكُمْ And the rest of the days he is on the earth is like your days. But look at the concern of the Sahaba. They said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَتَكْفِينَ فِيهِ صَلَاةُ يَوْمِ Listen to their question. In this day that is the length of a year, is it enough to pray only 5 times? قَالَ لَا And this is what proves that this day is actually this much in length. قَالَ لَا أَقْدِرُ لَهُ قَدْرًا Count for it and calculate it by its hour. Meaning we know between Maghrib and Isha, an hour and a half, an hour and 40 minutes. You wait this time, pray Salatul Isha. Between Isha and Fajr, 7 or 8 or 9 hours, you wait this time and you pray Salat al-Fajr. So this is how the Muslims will be living at this time of the Dajjal.